In the early 90s, there was an upsurge of Pacific faces on the telly in the show Life in the Fridge Exists.
Ever fancied yourself as the next Quincy Jones or George Martin? Record producers for Michael Jackson and the Beatles? Hi, I'm Oscar Kightley reporting for Life.
Yo, have you ever come home from a concert or a pub and had that numb feeling in your ear?
Want to be a rock star? Want to be on stage? Want to blow people's minds?
Talofa, this is Victor Roger reporting for Life. Tonight I'm going to meet one of New Zealand's top male singers, Dave Dobbin.
And also popular on children's TV, who could forget Catherine McPherson as the face of What Now in the early 90s?
I sometimes forget that people are actually staring at me because, yes, I am this person from television, and sometimes I sort of get a bit conscious and I think, you know, I've got food on my face, was my fly down? And you do, you start adjusting your clothes, you know, and then you realise that, no, they're looking at you because they recognise you.
Also recognised was Tokelauan favourite Jason Faafoi, who later joined the multicultural What Now crew.
April? That's right, Richard. And I'll be right there with the team.
I started off in regional TV before I started on What Now, and then What Now's presenter was feeling ill one afternoon, and with 2 hours to go before a live show, the producer called me up and asked me if I could fill in, and I said, sure.
Jason Faafoi.
Hey. And I filled in for that afternoon, and they asked me back the next day. I was filling out daily contracts, and then I ended up getting a permanent job there after a few months. They thought, oh, blow this, get them on board.
Captain, there's another communication coming in.
What Now was just an amazing job because it just felt like you're just turning up to work, hanging out with your mates, cracking some stink to funny jokes, and doing it in an environment where you felt pretty safe. You got on with all the camera people, everyone in the crew, and it just felt like good times, you know. I was there for 7 years and loved every day of it, man. It was pretty cool.
Yeah.
Hey, Mama, look, get your Mother's Day present.
Oh, son, you didn't have to give me that one. It's just for Mother's Day. Oh, wow, we are just. Look at that. Juju lipstick for really big lips.
I used to like What's take that? The mickey out of my family on the show as well. But, so like used to dress up like my mum, and she loved it, you know. There were times where she was like going, oh, Jason, I'm getting stopped on the bus and people are asking me for my autograph. And I'm like going, hey, welcome to the big time, Mama.
Mum, you're scaring me, man.
Come here, you little monkey, I'm gonna smack you with my chandals.
More Kiwi dramas on the screen saw the occasional brown face in the mix, and most of the time it was veteran Pacific actor Nathaniel Lees, who's played a multitude of roles and ethnicities across the decades.
How the hell did you pull him in?
United Nations nuclear sensors have detected distinct signs
of... I played Asians and I played these people that you didn't know where they came from, you know, because they talk funny.
Radio 1254, CB this evening, over.
My name is Jay. And,
and another popular brown face who also worked across many TV genres was Jay Langaia.
It's huge, it's huge.
A director who was doing a documentary on the street kids rang me up and said, look, we're doing an audition for a new show called Heroes, about four musicians who form a band in Auckland, you know, why don't you come down? I said, look, I'm not an actor, I'm a muso. Not a very good muso at that, but there was like 12 different instruments strewn all over the place. And I played them all. And then afterwards they said, look, let's just test you on some reading. And I read like I was from Papua New Guinea. I was just like, and I'm, you know, I said, well, I never thought anything more about it. But then I got rung up about a month later to say that I got the job.
Well, that's fine by me.
I did Gloss, which is interesting. You look back and you go, why have I got that mustache? that funky hairstyle, but you know, that was it. I think my claim to fame really on New Zealand television is that I'm probably one of the only brothers that never worked on Shortland Street, you know? And that's not sort of for the want of trying.
Listen, bro.
Would you mind not calling me that around here?
Jesus, mate. I don't know what all this has done to you.
You know, you tended to play the best friend of. You know, you were always the comical relief. You had to demand that they allowed you to play a straight character. You know, not one that whipped out a guitar and laughed like that, you know? Because A, I wasn't really good at that stuff, and B, you knew that if you did comedy first, they would never let you do drama.
And then, for the first time, a drama was actually written around a Samoan as the lead actor in Street Legal.
The suicide attempt is directly related to him watching his wife and baby die.
What I loved about David Cilici's character in Street Legal was that he was a suit-wearing lawyer who never, you know, resorted to having to use his fist to win a case. It was very much about being a verbal warrior.
Also a source of pride, in 1994, Tangata Tangata brought the first documentary series of the Pacific Islands to our screens. Fictional Pacific stories have been a lot rarer on TV. In 2003, we had the first six-part Pacific drama series, Lima Lelei, born from a half-hour pilot about a netball team called Mato Uma.
It has been a deliberate policy for Telepacifica Productions to try and train as many Pacific Islanders as we can. And so in this production, we've got a lot of people who have worked in the industry for the very first time.
And these were some of the island characters that have coloured up Shortland Street and over a decade of its screen history.
Samoan, Māori, Tongan, we all fall under the same umbrella as Polynesians. And that's something that I feel really strong about, simply because together we're really strong as a people, and
I beg to differ.
Shortland Street's huge in UA too, they just love it, and they were so proud of me, and it made me feel incredibly humbled, you know?
If it's a job that's your problem, why don't you fix it? Stop blaming it on everyone else.
All it takes is just exposure and, like, not hiding yourself, you know? Things don't just come, you know, things don't just come to you. You have to go out and get it.
There are also a number of lifestyle programs that featured a bevy of brown babes, like beauty queen Nicola Brighty.
This is my Cocker Spaniel, Pepper.
And songstress Nairi Coley.
Western-style horse riding is what Kevin enjoys doing in his time off.
Tiana Tofilau was the new face of Crime Watch.
The past couple of months have been holiday time for many people, but not for crime.
And we had our first Pacific Island anchor on the mainstream news. April Irimia first made the jump from being a silver fern to reporting on sport in the early 90s.
And I'm April Irimia. Tonight it's not just Aussie League, there's everything from cricket to motor racing.
Natalie Brunt in Christchurch asked me to co-host the World Youth Festival down there. All these kids coming in from around the world and kind of basing up at the Christchurch Town Hall, which was a lot of fun, a lot of colour, a lot of action, and that was great because I was working with someone who was really experienced, and she was lovely.
As we reported earlier,
it was absolutely scary. I mean, I'll be completely honest with you. If someone said to me you were going to be doing this, sitting next to Richard and Judy, I'd go, yeah, whatever, get out of here. But the first couple of years were harrowing because you didn't know what to do, how to do it, no training, no nothing. And at that time, it was a bit of sink or swim. You know, everyone was just waiting to see me probably end up on my face. And that's enough determination to say, well, actually, keep going, you know. And 10 years later, it's been a lot of joy.